Very good morning, children. Today I am going to teach you the very important and the most interesting topic in English. That is the figures of speech. Okay, we have lot of figures of speech in poem. Today I am going to teach you the very important topics. Okay, what is figures of speech? The figures of speech is to give some extra color, extra creativity, extra variety, extra message. The poet, they used to add some phrases, some words in their poem to add their beauty. They'll do this. This is known as figures of speech. In Tamil, for a bridal, you will say no bridal makeup. What they will do? They'll add more beauty to the bride. Now this is known as figures of speech in poem. Okay, today I am going to start with alliteration because this is the easiest type in figures of speech. What is alliteration? Alliteration is repetition of consonant sound, usually at the successive beginning of successive words. What are consonants except all vowel words? What are vowels? A, E, I, O, U. So other than A, E, I, O, U, all are consonants. So in the beginning of words, they have to have the consonants. Then it is known as alliteration. For example, the boys are busily bouncing basketballs. See the sentence, boys busy bouncing basketball. The first word, the letter of the word starts with B, B, B. This is known as alliteration. Okay, in Tamil, beautifully, I'll give you an example. Karka kasadara karpavai katrabin nirka adarku thaha. This is a very beautiful example for alliteration. All the first letter of the word, ka, 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 that sound, this is known as alliteration. So, in the parts of figures of speech, they ask you to find out the alliterated words. You have to check the same sound of words and the consonants. You have to find out and you have to write. This is alliteration. Okay, now let us move on to assonance. What is assonance? Assonance is nothing. Repetition of vowels. Okay, usually at the beginning of successive words. What are vowels? I already told you. A, E, I, O, U. In summer, ice creams are incredibly irresistible. See, ice cream, incredible, irresistible. I. The first letter starts with vowels. This is known as assonance. Alliteration is the first letter you have to have consonant sound. But in assonance, you have to have vowel sound. That A, E, I, O, U sound. That is known as assonance. Okay, now next one is anaphora. What is an anaphora? Anaphora is repetition of words. Okay, the first beginning of the words should be repeated again and again. Why it should be repeated? To give some extra value or extra message or extra importance. The poet, they used to repeat the word, first word. That is known as anaphora. Okay, now again we'll move on to the first one. Alliteration, the repetition of consonants in the first letter, and assonance, the repetition of vowel sound, and anaphora is repetition of words. Okay, these three are repetition with some letters. And next we'll move on to simile. Simile also very familiar with you. What is a simile? Simile is comparison, not direct comparison, we can say. If you are comparing two objects, no, you have to compare by using as or like. She looks like an angel. See the sentence. Here you are using looks like an angel. So this like or as, when you see any comparison by using as or like, this is known as simile. Okay, so you are comparing two objects. They have to have one common property. Here, between the girl and the angel, what is the common thing? The beauty. Okay, the girl is very beautiful like the angel. That's why they are comparing. How they compared? She looks like an angel. They use that word like. So, when they use like or as, this is known as simile. Okay, and next category, metaphor. Metaphor is nothing, indirect comparison. Simile is direct comparison. This is metaphor is indirect comparison. Okay, you are comparing two objects. Again, the same thing. She is an angel. Now in the previous sentence we used she looks like an angel, but here we are saying she is an angel. We didn't use any as or like. Okay, without using as or like, if you are comparing with some other property, that is known as metaphor. Okay, are you clear with this? Simile is direct comparison. You are comparing two objects. They have to have one common property or common character. No, it should be used by using as or like. Then it is known as simile. And what about metaphor? Without using as or like, you have to compare with another one subject which has the common property of it. Okay, so this is simile and metaphor. Next, we'll move on to oxymoron. What is an oxymoron? Is it a familiar word or a strange word? Okay, oxymoron is nothing. What is the meaning of oxy? It's very sharp. Moron means blend. See, the word itself having two contrast ideas, two opposite ideas. So when two opposite ideas join together to give an effect, that is known as oxymoron. Okay, I'll give you a phrase. Act naturally. Act naturally. What is the meaning of acting? Acting means nadikirathu. Naturally means iyarkai. See, two opposite contrast ideas joined together. They are asking that man or girl or boy to act naturally. Yelbaka nadi. But both are contrast ideas. Now sometimes they'll tell your friend or myself to other people, you confused me very clearly. Okay, confusion and clearly, both are contrast ideas. They are joining together. No? So sometimes Tamil we used to say ama illa. La amangrathu enadhu? Yes. Illa naka no. So like this, two contrast ideas we are using together. Why you are using it together? To give some extra effect. This is known as oxymoron. Okay? Then we'll move to onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is dealing with sounds. Some natural sounds or some musical sounds or vehicle sounds if we are using in the poem, that is known as onomatopoeia. Like barking sound or splash or some beeping sound or clapping sound. If they used in the poem, it is known as any sound, anything related with sound. If the word comes in that poem, it is known as onomatopoeia. Okay, once again I am repeating, the dogs are barking. Okay, the car beeped loudly. So the beak, the barking, these are all what? Some noises. If the noises sounds were used in the poem, it is known as onomatopoeia. Okay, then we'll move to hyperbole. See, the spelling is hyper, hyperbole. But you have to pronounce that not hyperbole, hyperbole. Remember bahubali, hyperbole. Okay, some similarity with this. Why? Because English is a very strange language. No, how you are pronouncing P-U-T, put. But how you are pronouncing B-U-T, but, no. But in the same way, P-O-L-E pole, but B-O-L-E here, you are pronouncing as hyperbole. Okay, hyperbole is some exaggeration. The poets know, all you always know about the poets and poems. No, they used to exaggerate the things some out of their imagination. They'll use some exaggeration. In Tamil, what's the meaning for exaggeration? Mikai paduthudal. Okay, so here, now if you are very hungry, sometimes you used to say, I am hungry as if I could eat an elephant. எனக்கு எப்படி பசிக்குது? யானை பசிம்போ, யானையவே சாப்பிட்டுருவோம் மாதிரி. Can you able to eat an elephant? No. Some exaggeration. No, if you want to complete this verb, I need 10 hands. We used to say no. Why we are exaggerating? In order to emphasize the burden of the verb, we are using some exaggeration. This is known as hyperbole. So, see, these are all very interesting, no? Hyperbole, oxymoron, onomatopoeia, these are all very new to you. So you have to learn this very carefully and you have to be very careful with the spelling also. You have to practice with all the spellings again and again. You have to write and have practice with the spelling also. Okay, this is what hyperbole. Okay children, so all these figures of speech are very, very important. So you have to have a very good practice with all these things. So you have to go through the poem. Already I taught you the poem Kazal. So with this tips, you have to find out all the figures of speech in that poem. And tomorrow in the next class, we'll discuss the answer for the figures of speech in the first poem. Okay? Thank you, children. Have a nice day.